Hello, massage nurse. Today I'm going to be doing the pathologies of the lymphatic system and the immunologic pathologies. I'll be talking about HIV infection and AIDS, allergies, chronic fatigue syndrome, lymphedema and edema, and systemic lupus. So I'm going to remind you again that this is just like a really short review of the pathologies. From the beginning, I committed to doing the pathologies, you know, for the students, for all the students all over the world. However, I'm not going deep, you know, into all of them. I know there's things that, as a matter of fact, after I watch them, I say, I should have mentioned this, or I could have done that. But, you know, I'm just going with the short version just to give you guys an idea about the pathologies for each, you know, for each system. So like I said, they're not perfect, they're not lengthy, you know, I'm trying to keep it short because videos don't do well if they're way too long. So anyway, just the basics, guys. I'm just doing the basics for you guys. So let's start with HIV infection and AIDS and what the difference is. You know, HIV is usually detected when they do a blood test and you have the antibodies already for it. Now you can go 10 to 15 years with a diagnosis of HIV, and those people are usually still very healthy, and you know, they're doing well. You don't have to make any accommodations for them because AIDS is the result of an HIV infection. So AIDS is already the you know, the later stages where they start, you know, they're more susceptible to the cancers, the sores, the infections, and that's what AIDS is a result of having, you know, impairment to the immune system where they've had, you know, three or more infections already. So AIDS is the result of HIV. You can go many years without, you know, having any symptoms until you start getting later into the stages. Usually the AIDS is when they have a blood work where it shows that they have less than 200 T cells, because it attacks the T cells that mature in your thymus. And the contraindications for that is you've got to be really careful with somebody that's already has AIDS. They're more susceptible to anything you're carrying, so you have to be extra careful, you know, like wear your mask and gloves and stay away from any open sores or, you know, or cancers. The point is just to help them to relax. It helps with the anxiety, with reducing stress and blood pressure. So, and another thing you must address is washing your linens. You know, most of the time all you've got to do is just make sure you're wearing your gloves and put them in the washer and throw, you know, half a cup of bleach and hot water, you know, and your soap. Read your soap instructions. You know, just these are some of the precautions that you do need to make. But like I said, when it is AIDS already, they're more susceptible to catching something from you because they're susceptible to anything because their immune responses are so very low. So the next is allergies, and that's an altered immunologic response to harmless substances for somebody else, but they're harmful to you because you're hypersensitive. You may have an immediate response or a delayed response. And the most common allergies is like to pollens and to, you know, to molds and food allergies. And some of them are, you know, dangerous, like to medications or insect bites. Well, insect bites are not as dangerous unless you get attacked by bees and you're allergic to them. But, you know, the one that's the most dangerous, the, what's it called? Anaphylaxis. That's the most dangerous one. They usually carry a EpiPen with them. And if your client does carry an EpiPen, you know, just in case they have an allergy, you know, I don't know, to peanuts or to a medication they took, you must always ask your client where they have that EpiPen God forbid, you have to, you know, administer it or take it out of the purse or whatever for them, you must discuss these things before, you know, they come in, because out of all the allergies, that is the most, you know, the most dangerous. The anaphylaxis is the most dangerous. The least one is like normal, regular allergies from pollen, where you go outside and 2 hours later your nose is stuffy, or, you know, dog's dander. Those are mild, you know, and like I said, it's just your immune system responding to these allergens that it may not affect anybody else, but with you, you're hyper, you know, hypersensitive. So be careful with the clients. You know, like I have my candles burning here and I love the scent of candles, but somebody with allergies might not even handle the candles or the lotions and potions that you use. So be careful with that, you know, that you don't have anything that's going to trigger, you know, a headache or an allergic reaction to your client. And I know I've had clients where they feel comfortable enough, and I feel okay with them bringing their own lotions that they know that they're not allergic to. That I'm okay with that. That's actually a very good idea. You can suggest to your client, well, if you have anything at home that you use that you're not allergic to, bring it in, and I'll, you know, you can use that. So that's another thing that, you know, is good for people that have severe allergies. And like I said, there's everything in the spectrum, from very, you know, extreme, you know, anaphylaxis, where it's very dangerous, to very mild, you know, like hay fever. So it just depends. Like I said, interview your client, make sure you find out what's going on that day. The next is the chronic fatigue syndrome, and chronic fatigue syndrome is a prolonged or severe tiredness and exhaustion and fatigue. Usually goes on more than 6 months, and they don't get any relief, whether they get a good night's sleep or if they work out or if they're resting, they're still always fatigued. There is really no known causes for this. They do think that it's a fatigue from your immune response. That, you know, I've seen this in a couple of clients where they had prolonged stress for a couple of years, you know, being caregivers, and all of a sudden they just become, you know, with exhausted, fatigue, and no matter what they did, even just mental exertion, filling out a lengthy form for whatever reasons they had to do, and that would just exhaust them. So chronic fatigue syndrome is, you know, accompanied, you know, by more symptoms. And once they deduct all the other ones, you know, like say, well, okay, it's not diabetes, it's not, you know, other symptoms, then they narrow it down. I think it's they have a combination like of about 60 symptoms that they, you know, they weed out, and then it's after 6 months of being extremely fatigued, their immune system is taxed, their adrenals are taxed. So you want to make sure and just give them probably a 3 out of 10 on pressure, because it does help, you know, to reduce the depression, the anxiety, helps them to relax. A lot of times even a strenuous fast massage will tire them out, and you know, you don't want to do that because they're already tired for no reason. So you don't want to do a very taxing massage on them. So they might feel a little bit lightheaded, a little bit dizzy. So you're always there to kind of assist your client and make sure that they're comfortable. Again, I remind you, the massage is about your client being comfortable and, you know, accommodating to their needs. So like I said, keep it like at a 3 out of 10 and talk to your client that day, see how they're feeling. The next one is lymphedema and edema is the accumulation of fluids in their system. It could be, you know, in between the interstitial fluid, in between the tissues, or it can be in the lymph. So let me explain to you a little bit about lymph, the lymph, the interstitial fluid, and plasma. Those three are the same thing. However, it depends where they're located that they're named different. Plasma is in the bloodstream, and you know, it carries all the nutrients through your, you know, through your system, and it can get out when it's in the capillary beds. It can seep out into the between the tissues, so now it becomes interstitial fluid, and then the lymphatic system comes in and reabsorbs it to take it back into the bloodstream. So then now, once it's in the lymphatic system, it becomes lymph. So lymph and plasma and interstitial fluid are the same thing, just different names for its location. So lymphedema, it's usually caused by damage from somebody that has gone through cancer or radiation, and they remove some of the lymph nodes. So there is swelling in these areas because, you know, they've been damaged due to, you know, to either accidents or, like I mentioned, you know, cancer patients. So an edema is just inflammation of, you know, the in between the tissues. The interstitial fluid is probably not being reabsorbed. So there's no damage, though, to the lymphatic system in edema. So edema is just swelling, you know, caused by imbalances of distribution of the body fluids. So, and the lymphedema is damage to the lymphatic tissue, and that is usually the massage is usually done by a manual lymphatic drainage specialist for the lymphedema, for people that have had cancer and have the lymph nodes removed. So you must be certified to do the manual lymphatic massage, you know. And with edema, you know, there's certain, even as massage therapists, there's certain movements, you know, like the pump, you know, at the bottom of the foot, where you just kind of pump the foot gently, that gets the the edema, the swelling down. And these are done very slow and very rhythmic. Like even the manual lymphatic system, when somebody, you know, that's trained, you know, the pressure that they use on you is only like, you know, the pressure of a nickel. And they send that lymph, you know, to drain at the lymphatic ducts. The right side, you know, of your head and your arm, you know, drains right here at the right sub. I'm backwards there. I know I'm backwards. So the right side of your head and your arm drains at the right, you know, lymphatic duct. And then the left one, the rest of the body drains on the left subclavian vein. So they both drain like right here. So what they do with a massage is they send it to where it drains, and it gets put back into the cardiovascular system, into your, you know, into the blood. So then it becomes plasma and it gets circulated all over again. So the manual lymphatic drainage technique is very important to do on somebody that has the lymph edema. And edema, we can work on those clients. So just be careful. Again, if somebody's having a flare up, severe edema, then you might refer them, because it could be kidney failure or something else could be going on. So just be careful with that and talk to your client. The next one is the systemic lupus, and it is the most common, you know, autoimmune disorder. They don't know what causes it, you know, it's just your body starts attacking itself. So it leads to overproduction of antibodies. It can lead to other, you know, like Raynaud's disease, or it starts affecting the nervous system, the lungs, the liver, and internal organs, because your body starts attacking itself. It doesn't know the difference between cells that are healthy. Remember that our lymphatic and immunologic system is to protect yourself. It builds antibodies for diseases. You know, they may last anywhere from 7 days to years that it'll recognize a dangerous cell, you know. So the lupus, you know, affects the joints. They start having, you know, a pain in their bones, their joints, like I said, the nervous system. So the massage is very beneficial to bring down their stress level, the anxiety. There's no known cure for it, so they just take medication for maintenance. So massage can be part of their, you know, part of their maintenance, you know, to come in maybe once a month, once every 2 weeks. You got to talk to, you know, to your client. So like I said, if they're having a flare-up where they're really not feeling good that day, you might want to postpone. You want to postpone during flare-ups, and you want to keep the pain threshold between, you know, 3 out of a 10. So they have, an overproduction of red blood cells a lot of times. I'm sorry, a low production of red blood cells. So it may cause anemia where they might feel a little bit lightheaded. So again, like in all of them, you always want to make sure, communicate with your client, find out what's going on. If they feel really bad, maybe postpone the massage. And this is only with pathologies, guys. Even reading, I've been doing the pathologies videos now. I've done like 10 of them. And I start thinking like, oh my God, these sound really horrible. But I'm here to tell you that most of the clients that I've had over my 32 years, rarely, do they come in with something this severe. And if they do, you catch it in the medical history. And let me tell you, your clients are excellent at educating you and telling you, if you don't know enough about it, how they handle it, how they're being treated, have they been released by their doctor? So that's why a medical history and taking 5 minutes before each massage, that's my question to my client every time, whether they have a pathology or not. What can I do for you today? What can I do? And then they can tell you, today I just feel like totally relaxing, or oh, today I really need for you to go work my low back or my neck, or so always cater, and taper it and tailor it to your client. And that's it for the pathologies of the lymphatic system. And until the next time, create a great day.